Bhakti stai sthiratara bhagavan jadi sad daivena hidaye phalati dibbo kishora murti dharmartha kam gatayo samayo patiksha mukti swayam mukulidanjali sevate asman dharmaart kaam gatayo samayo pratiksha bhakti stai sthiratara bhagavan jadistha jadiswat daivena hidaye phalati dibba kishora murti mukti swayam mukulitanjali sevate asmano dharmaart kaam gatayo samayo pratiksha Srila Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Today's topic, what do you mean by pure devotion? And after that, we can discuss the symptom of pure devotees. After that, gradually, day after day, we can enter into Rupanuga Bhajan, someday. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, Bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Previous day, I was discussing one point. If somebody asks you, who is actually Brajavasi? In one sentence, if somebody wants to hear from you, then what is the appropriate answer? You can say, who can satisfy Krishna 100%? Who can satisfy Krishna 100% through any rasa? Out of 12 rasa, he is Brajavasi. Because complete satisfaction Krishna can get only from Brajavasi, not from anybody. So now point is that gradually we want to discuss this point. The bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Natural function of your soul means which is quite natural. What is there inside your heart, it is already there. That day I was discussing the point that usually we find water in liquid form. Water, always we find in liquid form. But if we take water up to sub-zero level, we can find the water become hard, I mean ice. So naturally, water is liquid, but sometimes it becomes hard. So Prabhupada wants to say, bhakti is the natural function of your soul, means you are supposed to run towards Krishna. You are supposed to run towards Krishna. You are supposed to do seva with all your sense organ. With all your sense organ, you are supposed to do 100% seva of Krishna. It is quite natural. But we hear from Kirtan, Natam Thakur Mayare Koriya Jai Charano Na Jai Sadhuguru Kipa Vina Na Dekhi Upai. Without Sadhuguru Kipa, we cannot find any way out. Naishang mati stava duru kramanghim sprishatyanartha apagamo yadartho mahi asang padarajo visekam niskinchananam navrinito yavat Prahlad Maharaj. After 2 days, we are going to discuss all about Prahlad Maharaj and Nisimhadev. But actually, Prahlad Maharaj out Dadas Mahajan, one Mahajan is Prahlad Maharaj. Now, Prahlad Maharaj is speaking, until and unless you have the chance to get the dust particle from the lotus feet of pure Vaishnava on your head, you cannot rectify your brain. It is impure. It cannot touch Vaikuntha Jagat. Vaikuntha means without hesitation. Kuntha means in Bengali, Sanskrit, Kuntha means some sort of hesitation. In this material world, any relation you have with anybody in this material world, there is some sort of hesitation is there. Some sort of impediments is there. Your heart is not 100% open. Some sort of barrier is there. But actually, pure devotion, when you develop relation with pure Vaishnava, pure way, then there is actually Vaikuntha relation. There is no hesitation. That I wanted to mean previous day. If you want to build up relation with a pure Vaishnava, then you will have to become very careful, very careful. Bandho mui shabdhano mate. Now, actually what Prabhupada wants to speak, that all our sense organ, we should engage all our sense organ for the seva of Krishna. Bhakti means action. Bhakti is, maybe it is a philosophical word, I know. But bhakti means action. As per Sanskrit grammar, bhakti means bhajadhatu sevayam. It implies it means seva. I mean you should do something. So you see, bhakti means some action. Now point is that everybody doing bhakti, you can ask in devotional life, but what kind of bhakti we mean? That day, I wanted to discuss this point. Anyabhilasita sanyam jnana karmadi anabhritam anukulena krishnanusilanam bhakti ruttama. Then gradually I can go back to the first stroke, which I started with. Bhakti stoi sthiratara, this sloka I can discuss. And after that I want to prove that Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is established in this sloka. After that I can try to explain the Pranam mantra of Tirtha Maharaj, you can remember. Now, anyabhilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anavrita. Now point is that anyabhilasita sunyam. Anyabhilasita sunyam, what do you mean by anyabhilasita sunyam?
Devoid of any desire.
Anyabhilasita sunyam. Anyabhilasita sunyam, devoid of any desire, any kind of desire. But remember, I like to do seva of Krishna. I like to do seva of Vaishnava. That desire should be there. Gradually I can go up and up in bhajan to embrace Krishna, to get the embracement of Krishna. That is desire, that is pure desire. But first of all, from Veda, I sometimes speak this sloka. Evam manu me siva sankalpa mastu. There is a preliminary reward. Always you pray unto the lotus feet of Nishingadev and Guru Vaishnava, that my mind never go to any material thing. I like to keep myself free from any material attachment. And any kind of decision I take, it should be very pure. But in material condition, it is not possible. You can go on calculating this and that, but some sort of material contamination should be there. But as for Veda, this evam manome, evam mane, this my mind, should always think about absolute thing. Siva sankalpa mastu, siva mantra, shiv means sankar. And shiv means there is no danger. Shiva means pure. Mangal. Shiva means always mangal. I explain this in an article every time. So now point is that anyabhilasita sanyam jnana karmadi anavritam. Now point is that why you don't speak anyabhilasa sunyam? But one is adjective anyabhilasita and one is anyabhilas. Here is one kind of now anyabhilas. You swing anyabhilas. Now point is that why Rupa Goswami Pad writing this way? Why he don't write Rupa Goswami? Why not writing anyabhilas sunyam? Why not writing anyabhilasita sunyam? Actually, Rupa Goswami Pad want to eradicate this point. Anyabhilas. Maybe you have no anyabhilas. Maybe some root is there inside your heart. Who knows? That's why Rupa Goswami Pad want to eradicate from the root. Want to? That's why anyabhilasita sunyam. Anyabhilasita sunyam. But by that, I already told that if I think I like to do some seva of Krishna under the guidance of some pure Guru Vaishnava, not whimsical attitude. Anyabhilas Maharaj, I have anyabhilas, I like to make one temple. Not that. Be careful. All my word sentence is very scientific. Maybe you have some whimsical attitude. I like to make one temple. Who care, man, you are going to make one temple? Popa saying, you cannot make any temple. A bonded soul can never make any temple. You have lot of money, you can make temple? Popa saying, no. By money power, you cannot make a temple. A Guru Pad Padma, Guru Vaishnav, first of all, they build up temple inside their heart. That temple they take out of heart and put inside us. You do seva in temple. Up to now it was there inside my heart. Now I express in front of you. Now you have the chance to serve. So temple means Nityananda expression. Temple means it is the adhishtan of Nityananda. First of all, when we establish one temple, we do bhumi puja, land. After that, we put Anantadev inside land. We do puja. Then after that, we build up temple. You know the procedure. There is a procedure. So nobody can make temple if he is not in line. I mean, he is not in perceptual order. He is not under the guidance of Guru Vishnu. He can make one temple. Otherwise, your whimsical attitude is not at all bhakti. Your whimsical attitude is not at all bhakti. Now gradually I like to explain this point. Very careful. So anyabhilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam. Jnana karmadi anavritam. Why Rupa Goswami Pad not saying jnana karmadi sunyam? First word, Rupa Goswami Pad, first word is speaking anyabhilasa sunyam. Then second word is speaking anyabhilasa sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam. Why Rupa Goswami Pad not speaking this way? Anyabhilasa sunyam jnana karmadi sunyam, not speaking that way. Why? What is the secrecy behind it? So anyabhilasa sunyam jnana karmadi anavritam. Anavritam, unveiled. What does it mean? It means gyan, mayavadi gyan, advaita gyan, is not expected. Dry knowledge we don't need. Dry knowledge cannot support my bhakti. I cannot get any support from any dry knowledge. You can memorize full scripture. What is it concerned to me? Still you are not going to get Krishna. In Chaitanya Charitamrita one word is there that Krishna, you can control Krishna. You can have full control over Krishna, provided you love Krishna. Pure love. That much you can do. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Krishna Seva Shuddha Prem, pure Prem is awaited. Only this point. Nothing else. If you want to worship Kamdev, you need not go to market and buy so many things. Kamdev can be worshipped by Kamgayatri. Provided you want to throw all your sense organ into the lotus feet of Krishna. There is no condition, no provision. If you do it, then I can do it, then no condition. Pure devotee, pure devotion. So try to get this point. Annavilasita sunyam, gyano karmadi anavritam. If I want to develop knowledge of bhakti, if I want to get the knowledge of how to satisfy Krishna from Guru Vaishnava, I like to go through scripture, that knowledge is not prohibited. It is approved. That's why Rupa Goswami Pada is so careful to use any word and sentence. I am always afraid. I always pray to Krishna so that I don't speak anything wrong. By the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, I am trying to explain, but I am not speaking, they are speaking. Gyanu karmadi anabritam means, okay, dry knowledge is not approved, it is prohibited. So that's why it is written, Gyanu karmadi anabritam. Karma means material work. Material work is not, we cannot expect. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, while discussing with Ramananda at the bank of Godavari, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first approved, first point, karmarpan. From there on, Mahaprabhu going up. I can discuss Raya Ramananda Sangbad someday in details in front of you. You can go mad. So nice, gradually what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants to speak. So first of all, Chaitanya, first, yes. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, yes, when karma arpan. Karma misra bhakti, karma, karma arpan is very, after that you can go on, gyan misra bhakti, gradually we can go. So here we see, anna vilasita sunyam gyan karmadi anavritam. So you follow the point, why gyan karmadi anavritam? Karma, bhakti, I already told, bhakti is also action. Bhakti, externally it seems that I am doing some mayavadi, they are saying, you are doing work, why you, I am doing work? I am bhakti, I am doing some bhakti, I am cooking, I am offering, I am going to market to buy sabji, this, that, all bhakti for me. A pure devotee is each and every action is bhakti, each and every action. So Mayavadi, they speak, you are doing our karma. We cannot approve karma. But bhakti is not karma. They think bhakti is karma, but bhakti is not karma. Bhakti means the mood to satisfy Krishna. That is called bhakti. In the morning time, if Yashoda Mata go on reciting stotra, don't give clarified butter and misri, I mean candy to Krishna, Krishna became very fired. You are reading sutta, what it concerns to me, I am very hungry. Give me, now. So Brajavasis, they are all busy with seva, to satisfy Krishna. So, anna vilasita sunyam gyan karmadi anavritam, Anukulyena Krishna Anusilanam. Sil, in Sanskrit, sil means, sil is a very nice word which implies a beautifulness. Sil, a glamorous point one. And sil also means habit under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava. Anu sil, anu silanam. Anu means there should not be any gapping, there should not be any gapping. Anu. Anu means back.
Uninterrupted.
Anu silanam. Anu silanam means exercise. And also, as per grammar, it seems it's beautiful. Mane heart. My heart, my beautiful heart, is expressed outside in the form of seva. Anu silanam. Now, anukullena Krishna anusilanam. Anukul means favorable. You are doing exercise of bhakti. You are doing bhakti, I mean practicing bhakti under the guidance of Guru Vishnu. Okay. But first point is that anukullena Krishna anusilanam. This point is very dangerous. My name is sensitive. Now we can think anukullena Krishna anusilanam. What do you mean by anukullena Krishna anusilanam? Anukullena Krishna anusilanam should be favorable to Krishna. Now point is that Hiranyaka, Hiranyakasipu want to fight with Krishna, to give satisfaction to Krishna. He can beat Krishna, fight with Krishna with club and everything. So what you mean to say? Krishna want to enjoy Birasa? Krishna say, I like to enjoy Birasa, that's why I send Jai Vijay there. To enjoy. So, what do you mean? I like to follow Jai Vijay? To fight with Krishna? What do you mean? In Kurukshetra Yudra, in fighting, we see Pitama Vishwa fighting with Arjun, but still fighting with Krishna sometimes. Krishna also bows, arrow coming here, blood coming out. What do you mean? Those Mitra people, they are just mad. They are fighting with me, I mean with you as somebody. Come on, man, we see Krishna fighting with Pritama Vishwa, blood coming out of Krishna. How is that possible? Whereas you say Krishna is a Prakita, transcendental. Krishna is transcendental, no blood is there. But we see blood coming. How we can reconcile? First of all, you go to Gita. Nainam chidnan chindanti sastani nainam dahati pavaka nainam kledanti abha na sosaiti marudha ittadi. Krishna there himself giving this advice to Krishna, to Arjun. Arjun, atma, jivatma cannot be cut it with weapon. You cannot cut jivatma. You cannot burn up jivatma. Jivatma cannot be burnt up. Atma cannot be burnt up. But come on, how is that possible? That whereas about jivatma, Krishna himself giving this advice to Arjuna, be careful, I am speaking about bhakti, to confirm, to get rigidity inside your heart. I am speaking this tattva. Because my discussing point is bhakti, pure devotion. Gradually I can go on and on. Now I can have some sort of doubt, whereas Krishna speaking that atma cannot be cut it. But we see Krishna's body, you see, Pitama Vishwa, arrow going inside and blood coming out. Now what kind of argument you can think? Whereas atma cannot be cut at, and whole body of Krishna, you see, be careful what I mean to say. Atma, what is the size of atma? Atma, that atma is there inside your body, inside her body, everybody. Inside everybody's heart. Any beast, an animal, anything, atma is there. Not even inside trees, Even inside one dust particle, there is Atma. But in suppressed form. Atma avasyanidam sarvam jat kinchit jagatam jagat. Not from Ishopunishad. It is not from Ishopunishad. It is from Bhagavatam. Ishavasyamidam sarvam jat kinchit. It is from Ishopunishad. Atma avasyanidam sarvam jat kinchit jagatam jagat. It is there in Bhagavatam. Krishna giving advice to Arjuna. To Uddhava, Uddhava, everywhere Atma. Nowhere you can find Atma is not there. Maybe in different form, suppressed form, some relaxed form, open, half open, full fledgedly, full conscious soul, half conscious, dormant state. So be careful. Why is that possible when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cite him, Hare Krishna, Krishna. Why is that possible? Why we find that all matter, I mean stone and everything become melted like wax. Of course Chaitanya is there. It is possible for Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to open their consciousness, to unveil their consciousness. We cannot do it. Follow my point. Now point is that what is the size of Atma? What is the size of Atma? What is there inside your heart? That's why you are moving, fighting, doing everything. And that Atma is there inside your heart. That's why. Then what is the size of you, that Atma? You know? Balaguru Bhagasyo Satabhagasya Satodha Kalpitasya. Tips of your ear, just one point particle. You will have to cut it into pieces. Suppose Balagra Bhagasya Balagra Bhagasya Satabhagasya Satodha Kalpitasya. If you make it this into 100 pieces, after that each pieces should be divided into 100 pieces. I mean, you cannot see it. Even dust particle which is moving in air, it is even visible in light, direct light. If you are in darkness and light beam coming, you can see so many dust particles in air. It is more finest form. So that is the size of Atma. And what is the quality? You speak about size. Okay. Can you touch it? Is it possible? And what is the quality of Atma? To understand bhakti, I must discuss this point. What is the quality of Atma? In Vedanta Sutra, it is written, the gunat alokbyat. Gunat alokbyat. Quality, if you want to think about the quality, you should think about one photon kana, light particle. Gunat alokbhat. It's just like one light particle. It cannot be, you cannot touch it, catch it. That Atma is there inside your heart, and Krishna's whole body, from tips of your and nail up to head. All that Atma. Follow my point. Jivatma is that side, that Atma is there inside your body. But Krishna's whole body is Atma. Chinmay, Chit. Constituent of Krishna's body is whole Atma. Where is blood there inside is still to make you full? Krishna exhibiting this Leela. See blood coming out of my body. So that material people cannot believe Krishna's body is transcendental. They can fight on this point. Okay, I want. They should be deprived by Maya. That's why I engage Maya Devi to cheat them. I engage Maya Devi to cheat them. So that though they don't come to devotional line, pure devotion, they go to yoga. Yeah, go. dry knowledge. Go. All, huh? Go, go, go. Knowledge, knowledge is good. It's good, you go. I'm learned man. Huh? Now point is that, if I think this way, that Hiranyakashipu wanted to satisfy Krishna. Krishna is going to get some sort of enjoyment out of that. So we can fight with Krishna. We can fight with this is bhakti. Anukulena Krishna Anusilanam, what do you mean? This is Anukul? As per Sanskrit grammar, Anukulena Krishna Anusilanam means favorable. So Anukulena in this case means a lack of adverse situation. Very secret point it is. Anukulena Krishna Anusilanam. I can explain this point totally, but now for the time being, Anukulena means Anukul, favorable. Favorable also means there is lack of any negative point. I can also mean this way. So Hiranyakasipu would like to fight with Krishna, but still our Guru Bhagavati, you don't try to fight with Krishna. This is not bhakti. But you already told anyhow to satisfy Krishna is pure bhakti. Hiranyakasipu want to satisfy Krishna with Vir Rasa. This bhakti, that we mean? Arubhagasai, but this mean? But no. Otibhapti, anabhapti. This point, two point is as per Sanskrit grammar. You cannot understand this point. Very complicated. Very nice. Now point is that, if you speak that Krishna wanted to get some Vir Rasa, I mean enjoyment out of Vir Rasa, so Hiranyakasipu will be fighting with Krishna. Now I can give this argument when Yashoda Mata, as per Damodar Leela, wanted to save the milk there on oven, then Krishna became angry. Why you go away? Then throw one stone on the yogurt pot and break into pieces. The Yashodama, of course, not going to do bhakti. How we can see, how we can say that Yashodama is doing bhakti? Now Krishna is not satisfied. I want to take your breast milk. You want to save milk there on oven. So I become very angry. So do you think it is not bhakti? So atibhakti, anabhakti. These two points as per grammar. Very nice point. Now point is that, what is the mood of Yashodama? You try to analyze this point. What is the mood of Yashodama? Yashodama, though going running there to save the milk, I mean pot, milk pot, still Yashodama, she have full love for Krishna. But what is the purpose behind it? The purpose behind it is a pure devotion, pure bhakti. Because Krishna cannot take any milk. On special milk is there Padini, Shyamali, Dhavali, one, two or three, four points of Gomata is there. Shyamali, Dhavali, Padini, their milk have some special flower of Padma, I mean lotus. Krishna like that milk. There is lot of milk. There is no scarcity. But still, Krishna like to take that milk. If somehow I miss this milk, if I cannot protect this milk, I cannot. Krishna, whole day Krishna is going to take cheese and everything made out of that milk. Paramanna, everything. So, Yashodama wanted to protect that milk. So anyway, Yashodama's mood is to satisfy, to do something for Krishna, so that he can serve Krishna. Though externally some negative point we see with Krishna, Krishna became angry, but still, it is the point of love. It is the question of love. You are angry, okay, you are angry. But I like to protect the milk. It is first point to me. I like to save you. When Krishna coming late at night to Yashodama, Radharani, Krishna become very angry. get out from here. Giving instruction to Lotita, get him out up. Then somebody can say, why? Krishna is driven. Oh, go away. Radharani don't like to see your face. Go away. Now, what is the point behind it? After Krishna comes, then Radharani cramming more and more. After Krishna gone, Radharani crying more and more, weeping. Then Lalita speaking, just now you told to drive him away. Now you ask him, bring him to me. What to do? You gone mad? Just now you told, drive him away. Put him out of. Now you are crying, without Krishna, Sam Sundar, I cannot live. Why you are speaking that way? Radharani, why crying? What kind of satisfaction you get whole night there? Whereas you could not get proper seva from me. I lose the chance to serve you, and you are not satisfied, you are suffering, that's why I am angry. I am angry because I couldn't give you full satisfaction, you don't give me the chance, and you are suffering. That's why I am angry today. You see the mood. So, Brajavasi, their mood is very strange. You cannot understand. When they are very angry, they are very happy. Krishna become very happy. That's why in Chaitanya Chaitamiti it is written. It is in Krishna Das Kubiraj Goswami speaking. Piya jodi man kori karay bhasan. Vedostuti haityo haraye marman. In Chaitanya Chaitamita Bengali verse is written, Priya jodi man kori karaye bhatsan, Vedostuti haityo haraye marman. What does it mean? Priya, I mean those who are loving me, those Vrajagopis. They have strong love for me. Infinity love. No definition is there. Krishna cannot give any definition of bhakti. When you enter into Brajadham, Krishna, no word is sufficient. Krishna just failure to give any definition of Radharani's bhakti. Krishna is just failure to express in word. Because no word is sufficient. That point I can discuss gradually. No, I can discuss this point after. No parayang, niravadda sangyujyam. I can discuss this point, not now. So you see, Krishna cannot explain. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Krishna Das Kubiraj Goswami is speaking, Priya jodi man kori kore vasan, is those Brajagopikas, those who have strong love for me, I mean Radharani, Lalita, Vishakha, Bhartimanjuru, if they become very angry, they speak very heavily against me, I am very satisfied. Whereas a pure Brahman, he is reciting Breda Risha, Om Namo Bhagavate, Krishna, I am not satisfied. Some pure Brahman is reciting from some Veda, very nice, with say there is some, you know, procedure. This procedure in some bed, if you can, this finger and this, there is some procedure. If you break, then you can get cards from Veda. It is written, Shudra, they are not entitled to utter Veda because they can break rules and regulation, and they are going to get cards from Veda. Veda cannot excuse you. All perfections should be there in each and every point. But whereas Bhagavatam, going to give you big blessing. Chaitanya Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, I am uneducated, I am foolish. Okay, it's all. But still I am going to get bhakti. Because bhakti is not dependent upon gyan and vairagya. Bhakti is neutral. Nobody can say that if this is there, then bhakti can be there. ahetuki. There is no cause and reason, you cannot put any reason of pure devotion. So piya jodi iman kori kore vasan vedostuti hoityo haraye marman. So to satisfy Krishna, that is the main point. Now you see anyavilasita sunyam gyan karmadi anavritam anukullena krishnanusilanam. What do you mean? Anukullena krishnanusilanam, exact meaning, I mean finest meaning. I can explain different way, but finest meaning, what Prabhupada wanted to speak, under the guidance of Radharani, if I want to satisfy Krishna, that anukula Radharani, anaya radhita nunyam haririswara, this sloka I can explain someday. So anaya radhitam idi radhika, anaya aneno, anaya strilinga. So anaya radhitam, you cannot understand grammar. So anaya radhitam. So, aneno, anaya, this is a different Sanskrit word. So you see, anukulleno krishna anusilana means, exact meaning, what is there inside the heart of Prabhupada, under the guidance of Radharani, if I want to satisfy Krishna, do seva of Radharani, Krishna, that is called exact. When the question of strong love, there is no cause why I love Krishna. If this kind of question coming, in that case, Krishna become angry or Krishna become happy, it is less important. You see, one point I told, Krishna exhibiting a Sikh Leela in Dwarka. Krishna want to get one medicine, nobody can give medicine, exact medicine. Krishna prescribe his own medicine, okay, you bring the dust particle from the lotus feet of a pure devotee. You can apply on my head, my headache can go up. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also exhibiting this Leela in Gwayadam. Getting Brahman Udak, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibiting fever. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu getting water wash from a pure Brahman. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Krishna, come on! How is that possible? Krishna himself. See, Krishna himself. So now, Narad Muni cannot get medicine from anywhere. All 14 worlds running here and there. After they are ultimately going to Brajadam. They explain, this is the point with Krishna is suffering so much. So one medicine we need, what kind of medicine, what we can do for Krishna? But Krishna want to get many dust particle from the lotus feet of a pure devotee. We don't know we are devotee or not, but you can take dust particle from our lotus feet. Any amount, take. If we are going to hell, still we don't care. Because we love Krishna, we want to protect Krishna. That is the main point. So this is called pure love. So now, Anyavilasita sunyam gyanu karmadi anabritam anukullena krishnanusuranam bhakti ruttam. Now bhakti, what do you mean by bhakti? Prabhupada gives explanation, bhakti is a natural function of Vishwa. At the same time, you should remember, in your Atma, it is automatically there. But through practice, under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, you will have to express that point. So, whereas bhakti is the blessing of Yogamaya, internal potential of Krishna. Bhakti is the blessing of Yogamaya, internal potential of Krishna. Without the blessing of internal potential in Yogamaya, you cannot develop bhakti. Now, how bhakti, which is, bhakti is impossible, almost impossible. Krishna can give everything. Krishna can give mukti, everything, any kind of enjoyment, bhukti, mukti Krishna can give. Kamini, Kanchan, bhukti, mukti Krishna can give. But Krishna is not ready to give bhakti. Argument going on between Naradji and Yudhishthir Maharaj. Now Naradji speaking in front of Yudhishthir Maharaj. Yudhishthir Maharaj, be careful. You are very lucky. How? You are very lucky. How? Because Krishna coming to you, Krishna love you, have some relation with you. Now, actually point is that, Naradji speaking, dadati muktim sma na bhakti yogam. Krishna can give mukti even bhakti, take mukti. Smana bhakti yogam. Bhakti yoga, Krishna don't like to give because it is rare thing. Bhakti yoga is the rare thing, Krishna don't like to. Very, very rare thing. Krishna want to pay. Je yathamang prapadante tang stativa bhayamyaham. If you want to do something for me, I like to pay you. Krishna speaking. This is the mood of Krishna, always. You like to test Krishna, you can test. Anything you do for pure devotees and Krishna, the thing that is there inside your heart, you can get that thing. Vancha Kalpataru. Vaishnava is Vancha Kalpataru. If there is no devotion, if you want to get money and pratishtha, Guru Vaishnava can give you pratishtha. Bhakti is very rare, so Krishna don't want to give. So now, actually point is that dadati muktim smana bhakti yogam. And now, actually there is different kind of devotion there. Yudhishthira Maharaj is exhibiting devotion, doing devotion. Bhim also, Arjuna, Nakul Sahadev, Kunti Devi, Uttara, Draupadi, those who are actually different Muni Rishis, they are also showing some devotion. Those who are Mathura Vasi, they are also showing devotion. Those who are Jadav, they are also showing devotion. And if you think about Ramavata, Nishingavata, different kind of devotion. Prahlad Maharaj also expressing, showing devotion. Dhruva Maharaj also showing devotion. Pitama Vishwa also doing devotion. So different kind of devotions are there. That is great. Very gradually we'll have to go and go on and on. Hanumanji Maharaj also showing devotion. So they are all exhibiting devotion, showing devotion. But gradually you'll have to go up and up. Ultimately you'll have to understand what is called pure devotion to satisfy Brajendranandan Krishna. Not to satisfy Dwarakadish Krishna, not to satisfy Mathuradish Krishna. To satisfy Nandanandan Krishna, that's why Aradhya Bhagavan Vajasastanayastadhyama Vrindavanam. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu approved this sloka? I mean approved this point. Don't speak anything about any. Aradho, and this point I already discussed at the time of Gaurpurnim. Raghupati Upadhyay have had some discussion with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when Vallabhacharya's room there in Arayal Gram, in Tribhuvan, three confluence of Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, Allahabad. You can remember this point I discussed. Raghupati Upadhyay. Now gradually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to hear what do you mean by pure devotion. Everywhere Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibited this leela. Anywhere Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going, in Urupi, any South Indian place, anywhere Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always want to establish pure devotion. Ramananda Sangbad, same thing, with Sanatana discussion, Rupa discussion, anywhere Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to establish this point. What do you mean by pure devotion? How to satisfy Nandanandan Krishna? That is the main point. grade of bhakti. There is infinity devotees. There is infinity grade of devotion. Uttara devotion, Uttara, you know, the wife of Abhimanyu. Her devotion is more than Kunti Devi. How you can understand? Kunti Devi's devotion is okay. Draupadi devotion is also okay. But Uttara's devotion is more high. Why you say? See, when Dushasan went to take away cloth from the body of Draupadi, Bastaharan. At that time, Draupadi wanted to depend upon Yudhishthir Maharaj. First of all, Pitama Vishwa. Then after that, on the Dhritarashtra. After that, Yudhishthir, Bhim, Arjun. Then nobody can do anything for her. After that, with full region of offhand. Oh, Krishna, save me after that. Then Krishna readily came, and sometime Draupadi speaking in front of Krishna, complaining, why you don't come readily, instead? Why you come late? And Krishna speaking, why I am late? Because you, as and when you call me, then and then I come. Before you depend upon Yudhishthir Maharaj, you depend upon Pitama Vishwa, this, that. That's why you don't depend upon me. That's why I don't come. What is the fault with me? Then Draupadi is. But when missile was there, Brahmastra was thrown by Asatthama. Then Uttara, looking that Brahmastra coming to kill the baby there inside womb. Uttara not calling, oh my husband, husband to gone, already gone. Husband already gone, not speaking that way. Not speaking, oh Bhim, oh Yudhishthir, don't speak that way. First point, oh Krishna, first. Not second point. As and when Uttara looking that Brahmastra coming to kill, then first point, oh Krishna. So Uttara depend upon Krishna, first point. So nobody can know why you say that her devotion, nobody, there's no discussion. That's why you don't know. If we go analytically, then we can understand. Sometime we find Kunti Devi speaking, oh brother, nobody taking information about me. I am in trouble. Nobody going to take information. When brother going there, you know? Akrur going there. Then, what speaking? Kunti Devi, nobody going to take care about me. Nobody going to take any information. I was in trouble. Still today I am in trouble. Who is going to take me? Now you are coming. Kunti Devi's bhakti is very pure. I know. That's why Kunti Devi asking, oh, you send dangerous situation in my life. Vipadaho santu. I want dangerous situation in my life. You send dangerous situation in my life. Why? We don't want to get any danger. Even any devotee here, if they are in danger, then he call, oh Krishna, save me, I am in danger. You speak or not? Suppose your life is going, oh Krishna, please save me. You speak or not? Now Vishwanath Chakravarti is giving an argument. Vishwanath Chakravarti is giving nice argument. Pure devotee, sometime in critical situation, they ask him, oh Krishna, please save me. Then you say, Annavilasirathunyam, this is one kind of Annavilas. Then how you can say this way? Then Vishwanath Chakravarti is saying, okay man, in dangerous situation, that devotee, pure devotee is speaking, oh Krishna, please save me. Okay. But he is not habituated to put that kind of that kind of apple in front of Krishna. Never before. It is not his habit. By chance it is coming out of his way. Oh, Krishna, save me. He is not habituated. So there is no fault in it. So you see, very nice argument. So sometime we see, so now you follow that Uttara, actually Kunti Devi asking, keep dangerous situation in my life. But none of us in this material world, we want any dangerous situation. Yeah, if we are put into dangerous situation, we go to Govardhan and Dubur, come on, please save me. But still, it is not our habit. If pure devotion is there inside a pure devotee, he is not habitual. Even Radharani, at the time of water game, at the time of water game in Radha Kunda and Jamuna, we can discuss this point, but not now. It is very secret point. Krishna taking Radharani into deep water. After that, leave Radharani. I am going to save Krishna, I am going to die. I can discuss this point. Very secret point. Radharani crying, oh, save me, I am dying. And no kabilas there in Manasiganga, there also. There is very turbulent here. Oh, Krishna, there's boat moving. Oh, Krishna, we are dying. Please save. this kind of apple, actually, it is not habituated. There is no dirty thing there inside their heart. At least they want to save themselves to serve Krishna more and more. This is the point. Nothing else. So now you see, by now, so many arguments I put in front of you. Anna vilasita sunyam gyanu karmadi anavritam anukullena krishna anushilam bhakti ruttama. This is called uttama bhakti. Uttama is pure devotion. Now I started with this point. I like to apply this sloka in case of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha. This is the final touch mine today. So we can find all these qualities in the life of Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. We can find all these qualities in the life of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. I can one by one I can show you. Actually, if you have the chance to go through the life history of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami, you can understand. Otherwise, you cannot understand fully. So many points. How we can understand his body is transcendental. First point, we have seen Tirtha Goswami Maharaj not taking rest for consecutively for 3 nights. You can ask this point to any senior devotees if they are living now. We never see Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is tired. Consecutively for 2-3 days he is not taking any rest because so many responsibility, night time paperwork, so many coming to discuss. 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, full. Our Guru Maharaj also same. Whole night Guru Maharaj writing, 2 o'clock, some devotee going to bathroom. Maharaj, still now you are writing, not sleeping? Okay, I can sleep. Some point is there, I write, complete then. After the 3 o'clock, one devotee going to, Maharaj, still not yours? Okay, I can take rest. After that, dang, 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 ganta, avarti. Oh, today I couldn't take rest actually. Arati Ganta. In case of my Guru Maharaj, if you want to consult any Bharati Maharaj or any senior devotee, you can ask. Even at last stage, when I was there with Guru Maharaj at night time, we look, Guru Maharaj not sleeping. It seemed Guru Maharaj is closed eye, but whole day, tongue going, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. I have seen myself. I am in Vyasasana, I am sitting in Vyasasana. I am speaking rightly. I have seen. Whole night Guru Maharaj, tongue going. But outside people can think Guru Maharaj is sleeping. Namaskriti. In the life of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami, I have never seen in any sabha, suppose 2 nights, 3 nights, Tirtha Maharaj not taking any rest. He is sitting in sabha. I have never seen in my life, he is... I never see. I solemnly say, I never see Maharaj speaking expression. Tired. I never see. Day by day I discuss this point. So Tirtha Goswami Maharaj cannot cheat me. By the blessing of Tirtha Maharaj I can understand him. His body is transcendental. Without prasadam, without rest, without water, I have seen him. So many operations going on. But still he is like very calm and quiet. We have never seen dissatisfaction in the life of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami. Never. Always 100% with serving mood. 24 hours serving mood. 24 hours. If anybody don't like to clean the utensil, I like to do. It is my seva. It is my seva. Like the mood of Radharani. Radharani want to do all seva herself. But Radharani want to give mercy. That's why she can distribute seva among us. Oh Lalita, you can do this way. Oh Visakha, you can do this. And after that, you get delegation of authority. Delegation of authority in economics, you can get one word. In economics. Those who are reading economics, you can get one word. Delegation of authority. From higher authority, we can get delegation. Like I am getting order from his Gurudev. His Gurudev giving order to him. Then I am getting order. Radharani giving order to Lalita. Lalita giving order to Vishaka. I mean, Rati Manjari this way. Rupa Manjari we are getting this way. Channel, through channel we can get. That's why Lalita Sakhir Ajagya Kinkari Binoda Dhari Chepai. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving identity. Kamal Manjuri. Bhaktivinoda Thakur Kamal Manjuri. Crying. Lalita Sakhir Ajagya Kinkari Binoda Dhari Chepai. Binod crying and touching the lotus feet of Binod Dhari Chepai. Binod praying. Lalita Sakhir Ajagya Kinkari. I am unfit. I am not qualified to serve Radharani and Krishna. But still, causeless mercy of Lalita Sakhi. Causeless mercy. I am there in seva. And Narottama Thakur also. Narottama Thakur also crying. How? Kobe Prabhu Loknath More Sange Luya Jave Siru Pero Pad Padme More Samar Pibe. Henoki Hoive Mor Normo Saki Gone Anugato Narottame Korive Shashane. Narottama Thakur application, giving appling. Strong apple. Can I have this kind of luck, a chance? Prabhu Loknath can catch me and can take me in front of Rupa Goswami and can throw me onto the lotus feet of Rupa. Prabhu Loknath more kabe liya jabe siru pera path padme more samarpibe. When can my Gurudev Loknath can take me onto the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami and throw me there, leave me there. Prabhu Loknath kabe more loyabe, siru pera pat padme more samarpi. Can I have this kind of chance in my life? Luck? I am not so lucky, but still I expect. By chance, if I can have that kind of luck. What kind of luck? Prabhu Loknath more sarad sange loyabe, siru pera pat padme more samarpi. Henoki Haibe Mor is normal Sakhi Gani. Those who are pure normal Sakhi, they can chide me. Hey! You are doing wrong. You cannot do perfect seva. I like to hear that kind of chiding. You are always, you are unfit. You cannot do seva properly. When Narmasakhi gone, those who are Narmasakhi can give me, hey! You cannot do seva properly. When they can chide me. I like to hear. Can I have that kind of chance in my life? Rupanuga bhajan. So you see, in the life of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, we see all symptoms of a pure Vaishnava. Though externally, Maharaj not speaking anything about Rupanuga bhajan. Though. But secretly it is there inside his heart. Anyway, so this way, now, by the mercy of Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, I have had the chance to write life history. I can show you this life history, I mean, in Hindi. In Hindi it is in Hindi. It is in Hindi, you see. It is in Hindi. And Bengali already published, it is in Hindi. I can show you, but very nice. But small books, very small book, but if you go through this book, you can understand. But it's called Pure Devotion, how Maharaj used to lead his with devotional life, we have the chance. Huh? I want to translate it into English very shortly. So many seva and so many problem, I mean, problem means also bhakti, there, to solve some problem. Now here, you see, first sloka I started with, what I speak? First sloka, I started with which sloka? I started with which sloka? Bhakti stvaistiratara. One devotee, I mean his name is, South Indian devotee, his name is Billamangal Thakur. Bhakti stvai. Tvai mean? If I have pure devotion, to you, bhakti stvaistiratara, jodi swat. And inside my heart, if Dibba Kishore Murti, if the Dibba Kishore Murti adoration, as a picture, Krishna is 16 year old, playing on flute. Huh? Flute? Bangshi is playing on flute. If that picture is there inside my heart permanently, then what about Mukti Swayam Mukulatanjali? Mukti always standing there. Can you accept me? Mukti Swayam Mukulatanjali Sevatasmano Adharmartho Kama Gatayo Samaya Patiksha. Dharma Artho Kam, they are waiting to serve that pure devotee. Always waiting when I can have that chance to serve that pure devotee. Because he is not going to allow me to do serve him. Because he is pure devotee. This sloka is totally applicable in the case of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Ashta Siddhi, eight kind of Siddhi. And some minor Siddhi is there. I mean vital Siddhi and minor Siddhi some there. All in total 18 kind of Siddhi. Anima, Mahima, Loprakima, Prakamo, it's a 18 kind of bhakti. All can serve a pure devotee. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Jagar Prabhupada, Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj, they are the example of pure devotion. They are the vivid example of this sloka. I can give example, one by one. I can give example. One by one. Dharma artha kam, they like to serve him. 18 kind of Siddhi is there, standing just in front of a pure devotees, always try to serve their lotus feet. In the life of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, I heard from Guru Bhargava, 18 kind of Siddhi was there, fully there, with Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. But still, Prabhupada never expressed. Prabhupada never tried to express. Sometime we can see in the life of Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, Bhangshidas Babaji Maharaj, Gaur Kishad Das Babaji Maharaj, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. We sometime by chance we see this kind of siddhi. Many times I discuss in my sloka. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj coming from Vrindavan, I already discussed, you can go through video, I mean audio. Then Bihari is speaking, how to carry you up to Gaurdham? So long distance, how to carry you? You can take me in basket, inside a basket and put me on head. How I can carry? You take myself, you take me. Then Bihari take that luggage and put him. He is like very light thing, like wind. No weight is there. Can you carry me? Oh, Babaji Maharaj, now I can carry you. So light, I don't feel, I mean, tiredness. Now, there in forest, one tiger was there. Bihari coming back, going back. Oh, Bihari, why you are going back? Maharaj, tiger is there. Ha! Who told you tiger? No tiger there. There is tiger, I see. No, Gauranga Mahaprabhu Parsad, go. March ahead. March ahead. No tiger there. Bihari, go. Tiger cannot do anything. This is one kind of siddhi. Siddhi. This is one kind of siddhi. This is siddhi. Huh? Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj at the age of 125, dancing, who cannot move, dancing. High dancing, jumping high. Olympic game, those who are doing, they cannot come out successful with jumping so high at the age and speaking. Hello, come on. This is the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is one kind of siddhi. All different kind of siddhi we can find in the life of Gaur Kishore, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Bhangshidas Babaji Maharaj, Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj, they are in Kalna. Kalna there. He is speaking, ha, ha, with one stick in hand. And then one big jamindar, landlord, coming to meet. Ha, Babaji Maharaj, he is very angry with me. Then he go away. The next day he is asking, Babaji Maharaj become very angry with me at that time. One devotee speaking, no, I am not angry with him. In Govinda Mandir, in Vrindavan, one goat, coming. Eating tulsi vikha. Nobody watching this, taking care. That's why with stick I am in Vrindavan. Babaji Maharaj there in Kalna. Bhagavan Das Babaji Maharaj. Some devotee there, they inform, yes, at that time, somehow one goat get entry into a tulsi garden and eating tulsi. Some pure devotee, I don't know who is on Babaji Maharaj, with stick. Go out. Babaji Maharaj pass away in Vrindavan. Fine body going to Vrindavan. Though you see he is there in Kalna. This is one kind of siddhi. In the case of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, one devotee, a family, I don't like to speak name, crying in front of Maharaj, fasting. Maharaj, if you cannot save this, my daughter, she is going to die, blood cancer. Maharaj, please save. Everybody crying, everybody fasting. Maharaj saying, you must depend upon Krishna. Don't speak that way. No, you will have to save my daughter. Always crying, fasting. Ultimately, Guru Maharaj was fed up. Who are speaking well? Go to Vrindavan. This moment, I mean Tithi and Nakhatra, star position. That time you will have to collect water from Yamuna. And this time, exactly this time, you will have to go to the gate of Sevakunj and get some dust particle from there. Bring it to me. Let me see, I can save all. After that, I don't know what Guru Maharaj is doing. Guru Maharaj is making one medicine, giving, okay, you go and apply. Doctor says he is going to die shortly. Then Guru Maharaj give this medicine to that. Then after that medicine was applied. After that, some poison, I mean useless blood coming out of ear, from here, all blood coming. After that, the daughter for 2-3 days, like dead body. After that, she revived, and now she give birth to 2 or 3, baby, and there boy, she is now, big. Now her age is around 54. This is one kind of Siddhi. But Guru Maharaj never liked to show that kind of Siddhi. Guru Maharaj can give anything to me, but Guru Maharaj testing what he want to get from me. Like Jagannath Babaji Maharaj, someday Jagannath Babaji Maharaj testing Bihari. Bihari, I like to get lot of money for you. You like to get? Bihari, I like to get lot of money for you. You like to get money? Bihari say, Babaji Maharaj, I don't like to get money. You don't want money? No. I want you. Oh, then okay. Testing. You like to get lot of money, I can give you. Lot of money. Testing. In the life of Guru Maharaj, I have seen. Any devotee asking anything? Go. Guru Maharaj want to give pure devotion. He like to get some patishta money. Okay, this. Lot of money. But in the life of Prabhupada, we never see Prabhupada want to express see any kind of siddhi. Though by chance we see this kind of siddhi, small siddhi, never Prabhupada express, because this is against pure devotion. Whole Mayapur inundated by flood. Not today, 80 years back. Maybe whole Mayapur inundated at the day of Janmashtami. Prabhupada just thinking how to offer Paramanna to Krishna. Today is Janmashtami. Janmashtami, whole flood, everywhere inundated, whole. Nobody can move anywhere. That by chance one ghost coming with boat. On boat he put all molasses, rice, every food, and coming to Jogopati, entering Jogopati. Who is there? Well, with milk, and today is Janmashtami, with milk and rice, everything. Who sent you? Whole Mayapur inundated, but that landlord is sending me. Oh, really? Then this is one kind of city. In off season, one day in off season, Prabhupada crying, if I can get one ripe mango, I like to offer to Gauranga Mahaprabhu. I myself never, I have my promise, I never going to take any mango. In whole life, Prabhupada never take mango. Promise, never take mango. Like Shankar Bhagavan, you offer everything good to Krishna. All useless flower you can give to me. I leave everything to Krishna. All useless thing, what Krishna not going to take, you can give to me. Useless flower, they are from forest and jungle, you can give to me. I am satisfied. Now you see, Prabhupada, that time that was not flood time, off season. Then one small boy is dancing and coming to, take this mango, give, ripe mango, giving inside the hand of Prabhupada. Prabhupada doing Harinam in Nattamandi, going hither and thither, moving here, again coming, Harinam Mal. Some small boy coming, dancing, and giving this mango in the hand of Prabhupada. Keep this mango with you. Then, where is this boy? vanish. Then Prabhupada thinking, Ari, who is that boy coming here? I cannot see more? And how he can arrange ripe mango now? It's not mango time? Then Prabhupada crying. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming to hand over mango to me. It's very bad. Right, Rupa Goswami Pada, you see? And Kherikadam, Sonatan coming, Rupa wanted to give Paramanu to, give some prasad, Paramanu prasadam to Sonatan, but there is no sugar, no rice, nothing is in Niskinchan. Only dry gum, you know, chola. Gram, chola. They are taking sometime bread, okay, with salt, nothing else, no sabji, nothing. But how is Rupa Goswami Pada arrange Paramanna for? Suddenly, one small, girl coming with milk and molasses, everything, with rice, everything. Then Rupa Goswami Pada looking at her. Huh? Who sent you? My mother sent to you. That's why I come to you. This is milk and something. Then after that, Rupa Goswami Pada cooking, after offering to Radha Govinda, then giving prasadam to Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami Pada taking prasadam, just touch with tongue, then become. Fight like current. Then Sanatana Goswami Pada speaking in front of Rupa Goswami. Never try to express that kind of desire. For you, Radharani taking trouble to carry all sugar and everything in front of her. Never express. You give trouble to Vishwanandini. I'm very sorry. This is also one kind of Siddhi. So in the life of all our Guru Varga, Bhaman Goswami Maharaj also is expressing some sort of Siddhi. I can speak after, not now. Very beautiful Siddhi. You can laugh, dance, you see. All Guru Varga. Kesav Goswami Maharaj saying the Siddhi. So Siddhi is not... So today I like to explain this Pranam mantra. First of all, you try to hear this mantra very with full attention. You must hear. Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, his Pranam mantra. Namo Vishnu Padayo Gaurapeshtayo Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Namine Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Tirtho Yasaho Sarupine Katha Kusala Rasagye Sarva Siddhyanta Sangvide Trinadapi Sloka Murte Ascharjo Dharja Salini Madhava Prana Pratimo Twam Bhakto Priti Vardhine Saranagati Parakashta Sevanando Daini Kitananandi Matto Gaurango Sukha Pradaini Anapeksho Anahang Brato Sadhu Brato Dharini He Dayamurti Patita Pavanayate Namaha. Now I can explain this. Today's I give final touch. Okay? Today's by the mercy of Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, some stotra flourished inside my heart. It took the form of sotra and coming out of my pain. Namam Vishnu Padaya Gaurapeshtaya Bhutale. You know this meaning very easily. Simate Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Nam. Very easy. I am not going to discuss this. Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Tirtho Yaso Sarupini. Like Vidur Maharaj, when coming back, ये युधिष्ठिर महाराज स्पीकिंग तीर्थी कुर्वन्ति तीर्थानि भवत विधा भगवतः तीर्थी कुर्वन्ति तीर्थानि भवत विधा भगवतः ए प्योर डिवोटी लाइक यू व्हेन दे गो टू एनी पिलग्रिम आई मीन तीर्था तीर्था बिकम वेरी ग्रेटफुल ग्रेटफुल तीर्थी कुर्वन्ति तीर्थानि तीर्थि कुर्वन्ति तीर्थानि सो योर नेम इज तीर्थ भक्ति वल्लभ तीर्थ तीर्थि कुर्वन्ति तीर्थानि तीर्थि तीर्थ जस स्वरूपिणे व्हेन एवर यू गो टू एनी तीर्थ पिलग्रिमेज यू कैन प्यूरिफाई दैट तीर्थ बट समटाइम्स सो पापी दोज वर पापी सिनफुल जीवात्मा दे आर गोइंग टू मेक डर्टी then by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava it become charged they get charging like mobile can get charged so tirthi kurvanti tirthani tirtho jaso sarupini you can go to any tirtha pilgrimage you can purify that tirtha and you can glorify that tirtha tirtho jaso sarupini katha kusala rasagye In Harikatha, you like to speak Harikatha, full rasa inside your heart. Katha kushalo rasagye. You know how to give exact medicine to patient. Katha kushalo rasagye, sarva siddhyanta sangvidhe. You know how to speak Harikatha so nicely. And sarva siddhyanta sangvidhe. You know all siddhanta. Maybe sometime you don't speak in front of some devotee because he is not qualified but katha kusala rasagye sarva siddhanta sangvidhi and tinadav shlokamurte my guru maharaj used to say he is the embodiment of tinadavi tinadav shlokamurte ascharya dhairya shalini you are the embodiment of tinadavi and that kind of patience is rare which is there in your life that kind of patience is almost rare which was there in your life tinadav shlokam murte ascharya dhairya sarine madhava prana pratima tvam you are very close associate of madhav goswami maharaj madhava prana priyotam you are like heart You are like heart of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. That's why I write this way, Madhava Prana Pratima Tvam Bhakta Priti Vardhine. Any devotee can come in front of you, he become very happy to see you. He become very happy to see you. Saranagati Parakashtha. If anybody want to learn Saranagati, he must get the example of Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Maharaj. Saranagati Parakashtha, extreme Saranagati. Saranagati Parakashtha, Sevanandodayini. Sevananda. To whom? Gauranga Mahaprabhu? You can serve Guru Bhargan, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Sevanandodayini. If you want to serve Bhakti Pumapuri Goswami, you can satisfy. If you like to serve Gauranga Mahaprabhu, can serve Gauranga Mahaprabhu. If you like to serve Nityananda Prabhu, can give full satisfaction. So, Saranagati Parakashtha, Sevananda Daini. With Seva, he can satisfy our Guru Bhargava, he can satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. Sevananda Daini. Kittanananda Matto, Gauranga Sukha Pradayini. Whenever we see In front of deities, whenever we see you are going to start parikrama, if I am Nithai Gaurango, Nithai Gaurango, Nithai Gaurango, we see you are dancing. Aparad Kamakaro, Nithai Gaurango, we see. We always see you are dancing. Whenever we are moving with you in parikrama, we have the chance to dance with you. We are around Maharaj and Maharaj jumping and we kirtan with danda. like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, fancy. We have the crying. So nice kirtan, I am lucky. Really. So, kirtananande matto gauranga sukha pradayin. Your kirtan is to satisfy Gauranga Mahaprabhu, the sankirtan pita, pitaman father. Not for anything else. Kirtananande matto gauranga sukha pradayin. You like to give full satisfaction to Gauranga Mahaprabhu through your kirtan and dancing. Kirtan. Anapeksho. You never depend upon anybody. You only depend upon Krishna. Any situation coming in your life, any challenge coming in your life, you never depend upon anybody. You depend upon Krishna. Krishna is there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there. That's why anapeksha. Anapeksha, you are not dependent on anybody. Anapeksha, anahang. There is no vanity, no false ego there. No smell of any false ego. Anapeksha, anahang, brato. You have taken vow in your life to express anahang, to exhibit anahang, brato. I mean, there is no false ego. Anapeksha, you never depend on anybody. Go anapeksha, anahang, brato, sadhu, brato, dharini. If anybody like to give one example, one sadhu, we can point out. You look Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, then you can understand who is sadhu. Like at the time of Nishinga Chodhi, you can see Nishinga Bhagwan speaking. Prahlad, if somebody asking me, we want to see a devotee, then can you give one example? Nishinga Bhagwan asking. Nishinga Bhagwan speaking. If somebody asking me, we like to see a devotee. Can you see one devotee? I can point out. You look Prahlad. You look Prahlad. Then you can understand who is devotee. Prahlad 100% depend upon Bhagavan. Never depend upon. One rich people can come and make my library, make my Goshala. Who is the rich person? Gauranga Mahaprabhu you want to make. You can make? Huh? You can make? He can give inspiration to anybody. He can come. So, anapeksha anahang brato sadhu brato dharine he dayamurte. He most kind incarnation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He dayamurte patita pavanayate namaha. For fallen soul, you can purify them. Patita pavanayate namaha. I pay dandavat unto your lotus feet. Please bless me. Someday, almost in challenging mood, it was not challenging mood, I was full of love in Vrindavan. I was bound to write one letter to Tirtha Goswami Maharaj to say the present situation of devotion. After that, I was put in trouble. And after that I write one letter through one devotee, and last I say, I promise, I solemnly say, I am going to get 100% your keeper. I am going to take 100 your keeper 100%. Nobody else. Almost in challenging mood I write this. Almost 18 years back. Now I can remember. I was bound to write, Maharaj, be sure. I solemnly say, I am going to get your kippah, 100%, full kippah. Nobody else, I am going to tell. I promise. How I speak? Not with false ego, with love inside my heart. Now, today Maharaj many times came in dream, bless me, embrace me. Sometime, I mean 10 years back, I find Maharaj coming in dream with bowl and spoon. And Paramananda is there. Take prasadam, looking at me this way. Take prasadam, smiling. And last, after that, I already declared the Maharaj not going to say. Last time when I was Vradhikum. This way, Maharaj many times, still Maharaj is there with me. I can feel Maharaj is there to protect me. So, Vancha Kalpadurva Sikkipasindibhya Japajitanang Pavanabhya Vishnabhyo Namo. Now you can see, watch this book. one side, picture on the, all devotees. Back side you can see, and inside page, inside in hand. BBC is speaking. Huh. All age, you see? At a glance you can see. You can see. At a glance you can see. You cannot read, but you can see picture. This book. Very shortly I like to publish English, but bless me so that I can get make up time. So many time I lost because of some I like to sue Seva, but here there's no picture. But there you can get picture, one picture. Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. This picture. So if you have any question, you can do. I think I give answer to all questions. there should not be any question. Now you pass on this book, I can give this book to you also. Yes, that is Sarnagati. Sita ami bolechi. Ami many time I speak this way, we cannot show our Sarnagati directly to Krishna. Many time I speak. Countless time. We must show our Sarnagati through one pure devotee. This is the speaking. Sarnagati Shuddha Bhaktir Madhami Siddha. Ikata onek bar bolechi. Ajke kono bhala. So backside picture inside you can see. শুদ্ধ ভক্তের সম্বন্ধে যদি হয় তারা যদি তোমায় ভালোবাসে তুমি যে অবস্থায় থাকো তোমাকে টেনে নিয়ে চলে যাবে কিন্তু ভালোবাসা থাকা যে কপটা তো থাকলে হবে না ব্যাক সাইড পিকচার ইউ ক্যান সি অল এজ পিকচার ইয়ং না না ইনসাইড ব্যাক পেজ ইয়াস অল এজ
হ্যাঁ
Huh?
You made this question. This is what I heard. If you love, there is no cause.
Yeah, there is no cause.
So why do I love Krishna?
Now, I can give answer in details after, but now I like to speak in gist. Bhakti, Krishna speaking, Mai bhaktir hi amritottaya kalpate. In front of Gopika, Krishna speaking, Mai bhakti hi Mai bhaktir hi bhakti bhaktir amritottaya kalpate. Bhakti, if you do my bhakti, if you do bhakti to me, it is amrita, nectar. Now question is that why you show bhakti? Why? Rupa Goswami, Vishwanatha Chakravarti giving answer. We are showing bhakti, we are doing bhakti to get more and more bhakti. Understand? We are doing bhakti to get more and more bhakti. This is answer? Yes, this is answer. Why you are doing bhakti? To get more and more bhakti. There is no cause. I can give answer in details after. There is no cause. Because bhakti is itself amrita. It is not, bhakti is not dependent on anything. Bhakti, first of all, I can explain in details, but you cannot understand Sanskrit grammar. That I like to explain it very easily. Bhakti is not dependent on anything. Bhakti Devi is nirapeksha. I can give example from Bhagavatam everywhere. Man, you see this book. So you see, bhakti is not dependent on anything. So automatically, Shyam bhakti coming inside your heart, it is not depend upon any cause and relation, nothing. Automatically come. No material relation, no cause. Then you are going to realize, getting the test, then why you are doing bhakti? To get more and more bhakti. This is the answer. Because this nectar. So nectar, if somebody is something, why you should take this stuff? I want to get more nectar. This is the answer. In details, I can speak after. There is no cause. Tathavi dar karon thakte pare. Kintu er kono karon nei. Very complicated answer. Very. If you go up to that level, you can understand. Repeatedly, we'll have to hear this. Then today or tomorrow, I can enter into Raganuga Bhakti, Rupanuga Bhakti. Very.
Very. Dharma
Dharma So, any question you have?
What is karma pan? I don't know.
Huh?
Karma pan.
Karma pan mean fruit. Actually, those people, they are doing any action, they are doing anything that is called fruitive activities. They want to get some result. When you don't want to give any result, you want to throw everything onto the lotus feet of Krishna, that is called karma arpan. You want to give all on Krishna. Whatever Krishna wants to do, he can. Karma arpan. Understand?
Maharaj, maybe you can speak a little bit more about what is like Swarup Siddhava. Because now this...
No, I can discuss while I am going to discuss Rai Ramananda Sangbad. First of all, let me start Rai Ramananda Sangbad. After that, I can go on. Gradually, I can go. Sarva Siddha Bhakti. Right? I can discuss, but you have to wait. Now we... So, Nishinga Chaudhasi coming. We can start 8 o'clock, because I have so many bhajan that day. But don't do delay. 8 o'clock, I can start. I can discuss some point about Nishinga Deva Prahlad Maharaj, so that I can give some backing, power. Because Nishinga Bhagavan is going to give me power to go to any kind of problem there in my bhajan life, I can cut by the power of Nishinga. Okay, now I am going, I have seva. Oh, you have any question? What question?
When he
a question of love. It's a question of love.
Yeah. So, because devotees relish to hear these kind of loving exchanges, where Krishna feels bound to go.
Yes. Krishna feels proud.
But devotees to feel proud.
Yes. 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 That's why a pure devotee never request Krishna. Oh, Krishna, you come and give darshan to me. Never request that way. Though it is in Bhagavatam, we say, Gopikas, they are crying, oh Krishna, if we don't see you, we are going to die. That situation is different. But those devotees, if they are in material planet, they never request Krishna to come. Because if Krishna coming in front of me, then Radharani is away from Krishna. So I want to see Krishna always with Radharani. You need not come in front of me. You stay with Radharani. I am satisfied. You see, the more. I can explain in more details. Now I am going,
Ma?
Going. Last question.
Huh? Please, last
question.
People in the West, they are looking for Siddhis. Everybody is now kind of religion, they want power. Can you explain what you said, that real devotion, you don't expose Siddhis, but can you explain why? Because I'd like to tell people in my country, why do you
do it? It's very easy. Very easy. I already answer. You don't notice. I already answer. Krishna in Gita was speaking. Je jathamam prapadante tan sadimam. Krishna wants to give everything, all Siddhi to you. But if I take Siddhi from Krishna, then I am not going to get nectar, pure devotion. Krishna wants to, because Krishna is only satisfied with pure devotion. This is one kind of payment. This is one kind of payment business. Krishna wants to give you Siddhi. You take away Siddhi from me. Mukti, Siddhi, all take from me. Take. But pure devotee don't like to take Siddhi, because Krishna is not satisfied with Siddhi. Krishna want to say, Krishna want to see your pure devotion. Krishna want to see your pure devotion. Krishna can give Siddhi. If you want to take the Siddhi, then Krishna is saying, Allah, Krishna is saying, okay, he is taking Siddhi. I am sent. I'm not going to give this treasure. That treasure is very rare. Bhakti is very rare. Krishna don't like to give.
Even the
Because it is rare, there is a secret thing, any secret thing is very secret thing. Siddhi, those who are asking Bhakti, Siddhi, of course they are not in favor of pure devotion, 100%. Those who are looking for Siddhi, 100%, they are not in favor of pure devotion. At a time, two things cannot stand. There can be any desire, there can be pure devotee, devotion is not possible. Not possible.
That is akarma sarva. If you even you have desire for these siddhis, or you have desire for.
But anyway, this is instruction. You will have to do bhajan for Krishna. But if you want to get pure devotee.
Dhruva Maharaj.
Yes, part started. But regarding pure devotion, I am speaking. Krishna wants to cheat you with siddhi everything. Dhruva Maharaj is saying, I don't want, I am singhasan. But no. You started your bhajan to get position and rank. You will have to take, no Prabhu, I don't want. Today I get the jewel. You have to take. It is my desire. 60,000 years you have to stay as my representative. Then Prahlad Maharaj also. Hanumanji also. Ramchandra speaking, you will have to stay here on this material planet. Like a representative, my do Uddhav, you will have to stay here as my representative.
Vrinda wants to know if the mood of a devotee should be that he's thinking himself not worthy to receive bhakti, but anyhow is proceeding, try to please Krishna. Should be this the mood, or the mood should be, yes, for sure in my life I will get bhakti. Which
100% mood there should be there. I am going to get Krishna this life. Get Krishna means Krishna seva. Krishna seva. I don't like to put Krishna in trouble. You come and give darshan. What I can see? But you can give seva. That is what Krishna wants. 100% resolution. If there is no resolution, if there is no goal in your life, then you cannot come out. Goal should be there.